Good afternoon to you and Happy New Year, Happy 2011 to you all. Today we're going to have a look at the journal quota file system. On some of Novell courses we look at quotering, but they have stuck to the older, more traditional quota system. Since the 2.6 kernel, it has supported journal quotas, which really means that the quota system, the restrictions on disk space that we put towards our users and groups, is read from the journal, the transaction log of reading and writing to the file system, rather than from the file system itself. In reality, what this means, if there's a file system crash and you're not using journal file system, the whole file system has to be checked. Well, very much in the same way as with checking the file system, if we are writing to the file system and the file system crashes, we have to do a quota check on that file system again to make sure we're reading the correct information. A lot of people don't think of this, and there's certainly no need with the journal quota system because we're actually only reading data that was committed through to the disk. It's very easily set up and easily shown, and we of course add it in all of the courses that we teach. So here you go, let's have a quick look at how we set this up. So the first thing I'm going to do is just set up a directory for me to mount my file system to. So let's just make the font a little bit bigger, and we'll do then the mkdir minus mode 777. So we'll set up full permissions and we'll create the data directory. So that's created the directory. Now I just need to install with zipper the quota system. So I'm using zipper minus minus no remote install quota. And yes, we'll install that. So I've got my quota file system installed. Now I need a file system enabled for the quota file system. All of this is going to be exactly the same whether we're using the journal quotas or whether we're using standard quotas. The only difference is going to be in the options that we put for mount. So let me just edit my file system tab. So /etc/fs tab. And we'll insert a line right down the bottom, and it's going to be on this machine /dev/sdd1. We're going to mount it through to that data directory that we just created. And remember, the minus m mode means we can set the mode or the permissions of the directory at the same time. Now we're going to set the file system type, so it's ext4, and we want the options now. So this is where we put in our usrj quota. And then the name of the quota database that we want. So that's going to be, well, keep the standard name, so a quota.user. And then the type of format that we want. So we're going to use Java quota format equals virtual file system version 0. So this is the most standard that we'll use. It will differ depending on the type of file system that you're using. If you're using XFS or something like that, then it has slightly different options here. So we add in these two options where we want to use journal quotas. So it's user J quota, and then the name of the quota database, and then the Java quota format. And then ACLs or whatever, or other options that we want. And we won't do the dump check on it, and we'll check the file system but later. So we escape and save the changes. Now we want to make sure that file system is going to be mounted, so let's go mount minus a. So we're going to mount everything that isn't currently mounted from the FS tab, and then double check on that with then mount. And we can see just in the output down the bottom, sdd1 is mounted to data, and then we've got the journal quota file system. So really the difference isn't that much or that great to take on board from the standard quotas that we look at in our standard Novell and SUSE courses. So now that we've got it set, we'll have to initialize our quota databases. So there are no quota databases at the moment, so if I do an ls/data, we have nothing in there. But if I now run my quota check, initialize the quota databases, it's users that we want, we'll do it in verbose format, and we'll do it for /dev/sdd1. So we can see now that it's found STD1, mounted through to data. And if we go through, look in the data directory now, we've got our quota database for our users. Now, of course, we want to start the quota system itself. All we've done is initialize the quota system. And it's this quota check that if we weren't using the journal quota system, every time we had a file system crash, although it's not likely to occur very often on Linux, we would also have to go through and rebuild with the quota check here, the quota databases. But we're using the journal, so we can just start our quota service. So if we set it for auto start, so check config, boot.quota minus a, and then we'll go through and start it now, init.d boot.quota start. So now we are checking for files being written to the file system. So if I do a report quota on this, so I do a rep quota, if I can spell quota, of course. Uses some verbose on, well, we'll do it on alls there. So we can see the only person who's got anything is root. Nobody else has created anything, and that's going to be the quota database file. So if I now swap across to my urban user, so let's do an su minus urban, and won't create too much here, but let's just, yeah, cat slash etc slash hosts through to data file one, and of course we've got to send the output there. So I look now ls slash data, we've got the file one in there, we'll exit back and run my rep quota again. So I'll go exclamation mark rep for the last command that started with rep. We can see now that urban is listed there. Obviously the file size doesn't come into it at the moment, but we can see he's using one file. So if I want to now go through and put some limits on urban so that he can't store many files or use much disk space on this, it's going to be then set quota minus u urban, and then we'll say like for, I don't know, 2 meg as a soft block limit. And then we can set it for 2.5 meg or roughly, and then we won't have any limit on the number of actual files he can store. And then we'll set that for slash dev slash sdd1. Run my rep quota again. So we can see now that Urban is still under the limit with a minus here, so he's under his block limit, the amount of file space he can use. He's under the amount of files he can store on that file system. He's using 4 1k blocks, and he's got 2000 blocks and 2500 blocks that he can use. The soft limit he can store for up to 7 days. Hard limit can never go above, and there's no limit on the amount of files. He's got one file using 4k of space. So there you go, it's just a very quick look at the journal quota file system. It's not that different from the standard quota file system, as I said, or from the standard quota system, but really if you are using journal file systems like ext3, riser, ext4, xfs, then you do want to be looking at the journal quotas. Thank you for your time, and look forward to getting some more videos to you soon. Bye.